What's going on, party people? Shout out to the members of this channel, but specifically, shout out to T. Smith for making videos like this possible. If you want to do so, make sure you click that join button and become a member of the channel. So, you know, for those of you watching me, you know, I enjoy cooking, and usually when I'm cooking majority of the time, I do show some of the spices that are in my cabinet. And I've done something like this years ago. I'm gonna pin it somewhere above. But you know, some seasons, some things change, some don't. So let's get into my cabinet and I'm gonna show you some things that I season my food with. Now remember this, you know, before anybody's out and down there, order, buy seasonings that you would like your food to taste like, if that makes sense. Try different things other than salt, pepper, garlic, onion. Try different things, and I mean, if you buy it, you don't like it, just don't use it again. Yeah, and anything that I show here, you can find it at your supermarket, if not Amazon, if not, what's the other places? Search online, you'll find them. Anyway, let's go. Smoked paprika, I use it on anything I'm seasoning. It gives it a wonderful, wonderful flavor. If you know what paprika is, this one is smoked. Now, I found this on Amazon. Because again, I'm always looking for different things to spice it up in the kitchen. So I found this line out, of course. As you can see, special shit. And I use it on chicken. This is, you can use it on anything else. Let me see. I use this on fish as well. Yeah, see? Special shit is an all-purpose seasoning for meats, vegetables, and seafood. And we have another one. Big Cock Ranch. This one is salt-free. If you haven't heard of this, I don't know where you've been. Specifically, people use this for seafood, but you can put it on chicken as well. I think you could put seasoning on whatever the hell you want. Even if, say, it's made for chicken, you could use it. And oh, you should always have some sort of Creole seasoning in your cupboard. They have different kinds. So this one is, well, no, actually, I have this different kind of design. I didn't realize it's the same company. So you can see that I like Tony. I don't know, you say Karachi, Srirachas, whatever, cash, whatever. Because I have another one here. It's just different. The labeling is different, but it's the same. It's the same. And it's great on everything. If you don't have this, at least they have different ones. They have different colors. Well, it's different flavors. But you can tell by the cover and, of course, what it says on the front. But this is the one I usually use. This one is with pepper and what? Con piment, whatever. You can put that on anything. You can put that on anything. This is another one I got off of Amazon. Seasoning salt is good for it. Eggs, steak, potatoes, hamburgers, see, everything. I like to get seasonings. I mean, again, I would put, you know, you buy seasoning, you put it on whatever the heck you want to put it on. But just buy things that you know you can use it on several things. It's another one I got from Amazon, you know, through searching. Chicken rub. Yep, all I use is for chicken because it says chicken rub. I keep it at that. I'm sure you can put it on other stuff, but no, I got it specifically for chicken. Boom. Badia, you never heard of this? Badia, however. But yeah, it's simple. These are like regular stuff I think you should have in your seasoning cabinets as well. Boom. Red pepper, thyme. I love lemon peppers. I like to try different companies. This one is not bad at all. And I kind of like these grinders. I mostly get the grinders from Trader Joe's. That's how their seasoning come, but yeah, I like the whole idea of grinders. Like I told you, bro, lemon pepper. Oh. Black pepper, pepper, you know. Ground it up. I'm on a fence with this because, like, you know, I've used my pepper that's, you know, already, you know, you're shaking, you don't gotta ground it. You really taste this. You really taste the pepper in the food. Not like the, I don't know if I want to say spicy. It's, you taste the pepper, and so I use it sparingly. Now, if you've never had this in your life, please, please, you must have this in your cabinet. They have different kinds. Again, you choose it depending on your flavor, what you want. See, this is with the white pepper, it's a white pepper blend. Cajun. I think this is the, no, the red one is the original. But can you tell I like snapping? Look, and this is hot. So if you, again, if you've never,
Get these on Amazon.
Ground white pepper. I like his seasonings. They're all right. They're not bad. I think I have two of them. So this poultry magic. Yep. For chicken. I have the next one from. Don't do it. And I use this one for fish. Can tell I haven't used this one much. Everyday seasoning. Simply what it says. Everyday seasoning. What's in here? You can put it on everything. Seasoned meat, fish, poultry. Everything. Add to salads, pasta, everything. See, that's why it says everyday seasoning. You know what I was telling you about Trader Joe's with the grinders? I love it. Chopped onion. Yeah. I like to cook, but I don't buy fresh ingredients all the time. Very rare, because, again, I don't cook like that, and they will go bad. So I do, yeah, I like to use a lot of powdered or whatever the heck you want to contain, whatever the hell you want to call it. I like to use that instead of buying fresh one all the time, because it's going to go bad. I ain't got money to waste. I told you I like lemon pepper, so I tried different ones. Garlic. Again, buy seasonings that you would like your food to taste like. And if you make something that don't come out right, just don't do it again. Tweak it, you know what to do. Sometimes I cook it and I'm like, ooh, this ain't it. Garlic and parsley. Yeah, you can say I love Trader Joe's. This right here, honey. Grab! It's good salt. And South Africans. Yeah.
Oh, I have another one. I have one back. Oh, see, look at this. I have one back here. I'm telling you, it's good shit.
Potatoes and french fries. See, she finds stuff that makes it easy. You buy this, sprinkle it on your french fries. Don't use this and salt. Don't do it. Because in here you have salt, black pepper, paprika. Yeah. Because what I use to put on my hash browns, french fries, potatoes. Chive leaves. These are great. And eggs. Girl. And potatoes. How you doing? Cilantro.
Oh, I gotta buy curry. That's what I gotta buy. I'll be trying different curries. I'm not too much a fan of these. They're okay. But, nah.
Nah, I don't recommend them. They're okay. I'm trying to finish them.
Oh, I forgot I had this up there.
Ooh, orange pepper. This is good. This is a good season. Chicken. Ooh. Gravy master. This is good for, you know, you want to brown your food. Like, let me see. You just add a little bit. Yeah, so browning and caramelized seasoning. I usually use this. What I usually use this with? I haven't used this. Sometimes I put it on chicken. You can use it with anything. But again, sparingly. See, marinades and glaze. Brush on grilled meats. Grate on baked fish. Browns and seasoned gravy. Enhances soup. Yeah. My mother put me onto this.
And that's just some salt. Ain't that serious? And boom. Soy sauce.
Sell this shit hardly. What's the date on this? Oh, we still good. October 20th. I don't use, again. You got all these seasons, but you use them sparingly because, yeah, we don't want the pressures. I'm already dealing with that shit. So, yeah, so that's my seasoning cabinet. Shout again to T. Smith. Hope you enjoyed this. If you did, make sure you click that thumbs up or hit that thumbs down twice. Ha! Yeah, I'm out.